And here were the Memphis Grizzlies, focused on the task at hand as they came into the arena earlier on. And the game arrivals, sponsored by Express, dress like a pro. Looking down upon the Tower Bridge spanning the Sacramento River here in the capital of California. The Western Conference playoffs roll on. We're already down to the wire in the first round and exciting Game 7. 2K Sports proud to bring you this one. This is Kevin Harlan joined by Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and on the sideline, David Aldridge. Now, look at Memphis's starting group. We've got Jaren Jackson. Steph Curry is out there with Morant. Then there's Jackson, and it's Clark in at the four. And for Sacramento, they've got Insanity. Montrezl Harrell is out there with Bagley. Then it's Heal, and it's House in at the three. And it's the Kings to start out.
Here we go.
Douglas with it.
That's something you hate. You're trying to come in with an aggressive mindset, and that early foul could take you right out of it.
On defense, the Grizzlies. Harrell kicks to Douglas. Good ball movement here by the Kings. Five to shoot. Healed with the bucket.
And getting the offense started with a high-quality look down low.
And here is Curry. And there's the pass to Jackson. There's Morant. Over Douglas. No good off the back of the rim. On offense, here are the Kings. They're feeling confident after Tuesday's big win.
And really showed their depth when they needed it most. On the road, having to manufacture points. It was really that second wave in the rotation that took the offense to another level.
Here's Morant following the basket by Buddy Hield. 2 points. That one goes.
And how about the body control? Morant, even when under duress, stays calm, cool, and collected.
Now here's Hield to the paint. Here's Harrell, and Harrell slugs it in.
Never a bad idea to run the old pick play.
You're right. And if it produces a slam like that, we'll probably see more of them.
Especially if the defense is going to allow you to do it. Have to switch on that play.
Count that one.
He is abusing the defenders. Reason why, he's coming off the pick and rolls once, twice, making a defense work, and then a result.
Harrell finds Douglas. Shoots. Kings with the fresh shot clock. And he makes that one. Harrell's got his second basket of the night.
You know, you're going to have success when you can start out shooting 80% from the game. So early offensively, they've been great. That's the way you like to start.
Bagley with the block.
And a skilled shot blocker to boot. Love how Bagley uses that height and reach to stifle shooter.
And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Hield outside. Pass to Bagley. Shoots over Curry. Bagley, no good.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
And that one drops for him.
The creativity of Stephen Curry is on full display right there.
The Kings have gotten 4 of 6 field goal attempts to drop in the first quarter. Pass to House. They kick out to Heal. Drops in the tray. Heal's got 7 points in the game.
And you've got to be up on Heal, especially when he's beyond the arc If not, he'll burn you.
On the wing, Jackson. Here's Clark. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Over Harrell. No good from Clark. Kings leading now by three. To the middle. Here's Bagley. Some solid defense there from Jackson. Grizzlies shooting it from their comfort zone so far. In this one, 57% from the field. That one falls.
And guys, we talk all the time about making the extra pass. Clark there proving how important that concept is.
So the Kings call timeout. They're first. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, I had a chance to catch up with Luke Walton. He thinks pace will be a big factor. He said, we have to play this game at our speed. That's how we've been successful all year. And that's how we're going to try to win tonight. With home court advantage in this last game, Kevin, he feels confident they can do just that. Back to you.
Okay, David, thanks. Four for the Kings. Memphis also making some changes. Crowder, he's checked in for Clark. Dorian Finney-Smith comes in for Josh Jackson. And it's De'Anthony Melton in for Morant. Now, here's Holmes. Passes it to Bielitsa. Some nice ball movement here by the Kings. Bogdanovich looking around. Shot clock at six. Farrell for three. And once again, off the mark by Sacramento. And here's Melton. He'll bring it up for the Memphis Grizzlies. They trail by one. Outside Curry. A miss that time would have put him up.
Offensively, that's how you want to end the possession, except for the result.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
That's his first personal foul.
The Kings shooting their first free throws of the night.
Bogdanovich taking two shots.
And that one misses. Good on the second free throw. The Grizzlies have gone 5 of 9 from the field here in the first. The pass to Melton. Back to Curry. Outside Crowder. Pass to Melton. Crowder against Bielitsa. Shot clock at 5. No luck that time on the shot that would have put them on top. There's the alley-oop. And out of bounds as Memphis gains possession.
Grizzlies ball.
So the Grizzlies making a change here. Hill's checked in.
Solomon Hill.
Memphis trailing here. Curry deciding where to go with it. And that basket is going to count. Goaltending the official call.
So close to getting the block there. You can live with those calls because you'd rather have a guy playing aggressive instead of playing it safe.
Sacramento's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Outside Bogdanovich. About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. Holmes. That's in, and he found his range with that one. Now 1-for-2. And so here's Memphis. Trailing by two. Outside Curry. From deep three-point range, and the Grizzlies get it back. from deep. And no good on the last second attempt this time. One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far. Kings lead by two. And we'll be back shortly for the start of the second quarter. Steph Curry talks about the visual drills he does to help his playmaking in the NBA.
It's a cognitive and neurological drill that helps you, one, takes your mind off the basketball, because when you're in a game, that should be the last thing you're thinking about. There's so many other variables out there that you have to kind of survey, you know, where your defender is, where your teammates are, where you are in relation to the basket and your reaction. So those lights kind of train you in that regard. You have to, you know, see what the color is, make a determination of what move that corresponds to, execute the move, and then finish the jumper.
The improvement he's made, Greg, in his ball handling has really unlocked his game.
I mean, able to keep his head up as he attacks off the dribble, read the defense, and drills like that can only help.
And we're back courtside at Game 7 as this series comes to a head. And looking at what we've seen from Sacramento so far, guys, what do you think?
I love their effort, contesting shots, trying to intimidate here early on.
And you can see it's already having an impact. It can cause shooters to think twice.
Farrell is out there with B. Then there's Rashawn Holmes. Then it's Nemanja Bjelica. And it's Bogdanović in at the three spot. That's the five to begin the second quarter for the Kings. Here's B. That shot off. Hill with some nice D. And here are the Grizzlies now. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
Jay Crowder, blue-collar combo forward, finds ways to outwork you.
The Grizzlies shooting their first free throws of the game.
At the line for two.
Shooting two.
And the free throw is good, now leading by one.
The contributions from Jay Crowder are extremely valuable because of his defense, toughness, and switchability.
Harry Giles has checked in for Yogi Ferrell. And Memphis also making a switch. Anderson's checked in. And both free throws good from Crowder. Quarter number two, we're about a minute in. Latre, again the miss by the Kings. The Grizzlies shooting 47%, pretty solid. Curry on the wing. And again, Memphis no good.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Here's B. He gets that one. B's got the game tied up here for the Kings.
Poor interior defense. If you play him soft, he's going to kill you.
Here's Curry, and another miss by Memphis.
And I was sure that was money on that one, but everyone is afforded an easy miss or two.
Yes, let's look on the bright side. You got a great look. It's a play that you might want to go back to again.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Quarter number two, we're about 2 minutes in. The step back jumper is good. Curry's got 12 in the game.
I'll tell you, Steph is giving the fans their money's worth.
Pass to Bjelica. Six to shoot. Passes it to Holmes. Around James, and it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. A big group substitution here for Sacramento. Harrell, he's checked in for Rashawn Holmes. Daniel House comes in for Bjelica. Buddy Hield, he's checked in for Bogdan Bogdanović. And it's insanity in for B. Memphis also making some changes. Jaren Jackson. He's checked in for Hill. Jackson comes in for Jay Crowder. And it's Morant in for DeAnthony Melton.
Douglas.
And the rugged toughness of Morant. Excellent at fighting through there and capitalizing in style.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. Good from Morant.
And the work ethic that Morant has sets him up nicely. Make no mistake, this guy wants to be an all-time great.
Now here's Douglas. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. The pass to Harrell. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. That's on Josh Jackson.
Clearly a foul.
Sacramento shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
Harrell!
Two shots.
The first free throw is good.
What I appreciate about Harrell is how hard he's worked on his skill set. The jumper, the post moves, and the passing.
Marvin Bagley's checked in for Sacramento. Both shots good from the stripe. Here's Curry, 12 points for him. Now about 3 minutes gone in this second quarter of basketball. Jackson against Bagley. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up.
And Jackson has got the complete package down low. Loves putting the D in a compromising position.
The Grizzlies shooting their fourth and fifth shots at the foul line in the game. That free throw missing.
And they are excited about Jackson, a high motor guy with a ton of room to grow and also displays terrific leadership on both ends.
And the second free throw, good.
As we've gotten closer to halftime, their style has become more and more physical.
And here's Hield. He'll bring it up for the Sacramento Kings, trailing by two. Kicks to House. Pass to Harrell. And it's good for two. Harrell's got it all tied up now for the Kings.
What a great shot. This is why Harrell shoots over 60% for his career.
And stolen by Harrell. Douglas surveying the D. Bagley with a wide open look. And it's off from three-point range. Memphis has gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Here's Anderson. First shot, first best. He's out of the blocks fast.
Way to convert through contact, Kyle, with excellent body control.
Hield against Jackson and out of bounds as the Grizzlies gain possession.
Grizzlies ball.
Clark is checked in for Kyle Anderson.
Brandon. Clark.
1:57 left in the first half. Outside Jackson. Oh. outside Curry. From deep three-point range, sinks it. What range from outside. Wow. Curry's got the lead up to five now for the Grizzlies. For Sacramento, they've gone 3 of 8 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. Douglas with it. He's picked up by Morant. Here is House. He's still scoreless so far in this one. 1:14 left to play here in the second quarter.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Now here's Douglas. Heeled outside. Pass to Harrell. And he banks in the lane. Harrell's got 6 in the quarter.
Getting hit on the way up, the ability to finish in traffic might be Harrell's strongest attribute offensively.
Now here's Curry, 17 points in the game. Jackson misses. The Kings trail by 5. Now Douglas on the wing, heel. That's in, coming off a nice assist from Douglas. And that's now 10 points for Buddy Hield.
That's the pass you want. Orchestrating the offense, creating for others.
Curry against Hield. Fires it up. Curry can't get it to go. To the inside. And the bucket is good. 3-point play chance here for him.
How about that one? Able to maintain control and finish the play.
The Kings shooting their 5th attempt at the line in the game.
Buddy Hield.
Shooting just one.
And they now lead as the free throw drops for him.
We all know Hield can shoot it, but for him to get better, he's got to keep adding different dimensions to his game.
And that'll do it for the first half, a competitive game so far. The Kings on top, up 1. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much. Steph, coach said that you had to make them feel you physically in this game. How important is it to continue doing that in the second half?
That's a big deal. I mean, just being physical and, you know, make the right plays and then hopefully put ourselves in good position to win.
We'll see what happens. Thanks, Steph. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, thank you, David. And folks, don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number 3.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, everybody. SRO, standing room only.
Ooh, nice.
I'm your host, Ernie Johnson. Got Shaq here, got Kenny the Jet. Looking at the Kings, they're 1 half away from finally moving on in this series. The pressure of Game 7 may be weighing heavily on them, and they've still got their work cut out in the second half, but they're in a pretty good position. What'd you think about Sacramento, Kenny?
Well, so far they won the battle of assists. They played more patiently and very unselfish in the first half. Good shot selection and nice flow of offense.
And Shaq, let's get your input on the Grizzlies.
They did some good things, but the defense could have been much better. They allowed too many open looks, allowed the other team to make over half the shots. Some of that is not getting enough pressure on the ball, not really contesting at the rim. They look good, but not good enough.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final
horn. Oh, buzzer.
NBA playoff round one. Thanks for joining us as we get back to the action on the court. Really an incredible game from Stephen Curry.
His play so far is what fans love about him. He has gone right at the defense time and time again.
And not standing around, not settling for perimeter shots. He's looking to attack.
And we're happy to have you back for more playoff basketball here in round one. And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. So the Grizzlies five right now. Clark is out there with Jackson. Then it's Morant. Then there's Jackson. And it's Curry in at the two. Here's Heald following the basket by Ja Morant. Pass to Douglas for three. Hands it from downtown. Douglas has got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. This game has a lot of character here in the third period. Six changes of the lead here.
Intensity is the theme for this.
Now here's Curry. 17 points in the game. Clock at six. Jackson misses. The Kings leading. Douglas with it. Out of hand on it.
Well, you see the insane vertical, the long arms. Morant impacts every aspect of the game.
Basket counts. Morant's got the game tied up here for the Grizzlies.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
Right around a minute and a half played here in the third quarter. The pass to Harrell. Let's it fly from 18. It's rebounded by Memphis. Jackson's got five rebounds tonight. Curry with it. Now guarded by Heald. Kept alive. Bagley against Jackson. Another shot. They shoot again. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Easy to appreciate the physicality that Clark plays with. This is what earns him those calls.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. First one falls for.
The potential is there. For Clark, it's about expanding the range so that it makes him more versatile offensively.
Here's what Sacramento's going with right now. Rashawn Holmes, he's checked in for Montrezl Harrell. Harry Giles comes in for Bagley, and it's Bogdanovich in for Heal. The Grizzlies also changing it up. Anderson comes in for Curry, and it's Crowder in for Josh Jackson. So it's Bogdanovich who brings up the ball for the Sacramento Kings. A two-point game. This one for three. And the rebound goes to the Grizzlies.
Only one for four in this half. Sometimes it's execution. Sometimes the shots just don't go down.
A strong finisher. Morant doesn't mess around when he's got ideal positioning like that.
Bounce pass Bogdanovich. Here's Holmes. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. That's on Jaren Jackson.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact.
The Kings have only one missed free throw. They've had five attempts and made four of them.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw good from Holmes. DeAnthony Melton, he's checked in for the Grizzlies. And good on the second, so he makes them both.
Because he knows he makes a living at the line, he invites contact and sometimes even initiates it.
Morant passes to Melton, and good that time. Melton's got his first 2 points of the night.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Bogdanović left side. They get it back. Holmes. And Holmes throws it down.
There's no bigger play in a close game than a putback slam.
Oh, and that one's got them all hyped up. Wow.
They're bringing the energy, the hustle, the fight, and they also didn't give up on that possession.
Now here's Douglas following the miss by John Morant. Douglas, the pass to Bogdanović. Down low, got a piece of it. Outside, House. It's not going to go for him. Now the Grizzlies take it the other way. Anderson dishes to Morant. Two free throws second coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
That's his first personal foul.
For Memphis, they have shot 6 of 7 at the line.
Jared Jackson. Taking two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Some changes for Sacramento. Bjelica, he checks in for Daniel House. Yogi Ferro comes in for Bogdan Bogdanović. And B's subbed in for Insanity. Dorian Finney-Smith checked in for Memphis. And so Jackson nails both of them.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
B, the pass to Holmes. Inside. And it's Morant with the rebound. Memphis leading by 4. And the shot's good from Crowder.
He's so strong. Jay Crowder overcoming physical defense with great power and body control.
Has to be. Lays it up off the glass.
I mean, if the defender is going to play off like that, then you know what's going to happen. There are going to be points put on the board.
Here's Morant. And denied. He sends it right off the glass. Here's B. No good on the shot.
He's had a tough time getting it going, and he's put this team behind the eight ball.
To Farrell, unloads from 13, and that one good.
He always has the green light to take those kinds of shots because he is absolutely lethal from there.
Here's Morant. Rebound by the Kings.
What a defensive play. Gets the stop and does it without fouling.
Here's B, and he hits it to tie the game up. B's got 4 points now in the quarter. Passes it to Melton. There's 48 seconds left to play in the third. Floats one up and foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
You know, I love how he absorbs the foul and still had a chance to knock that one down.
The Grizzlies have knocked down 8 of 9 free throw attempts. I'd say those numbers read pretty well. The first one falls. And some changes here for the Kings. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Rashawn Holmes. Bagley comes in for Giles. And it's Buddy Hield in for Farrell. Solomon Hill, he's checked in for Memphis. Josh Jackson comes in for Crowder. He doesn't get the second one.
You know he wanted to knock down all his shots at the line, but he still did enough to put them in front.
Heeled right side. 24 seconds left to play in the third. And here's Hill, who will bring it up for the Grizzlies. They lead by one. Melton passes to Hill, and the shot is good. Hill's got his first basket.
Unselfish, moving the ball. Love to see this kind of offense.
And here is Hill. Here's B. Off target from three-point range. And we just finished the third quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. Grizzlies lead by three. Live from Golden 1 Center, you're watching 2K Sports. And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
And definitely deserving of the prize tonight. How about the read he made here? Looking like a point guard, putting the pass right on the money.
Yeah, it's one thing to find the guy. It's another to deliver the ball where he can do something with it. Wonderful play.
Well, it doesn't get much better than playoff basketball. Let's get back to the action here in round one. Bagley is out there with Bialysi. Then there's Buddy Hield. Then there's Harrell. And it's B in at the one. So that's the five in the game for Sacramento. Clark.
That's his second personal.
Shooting for Sacramento.
B.
At the line for two.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. He's perfect from the line this time. Memphis leading. Here's Morant. Good for basket number six from him in the contest. He's shooting 6 for 12.
And for a great shooter, Morant really works for high percentage shots. Loves to take it inside.
Outside. There's Harrell. And that one drops.
Yeah, he's in such a great rhythm right now. Makes sense to get him the ball any way you can.
Let him decide whether to shoot it, whether to pass it. He's your catalyst right now.
It's Curry outside. Drains it from beyond the arc. Curry's got 20 points.
This is what the fans come to see. Steph at his finest, putting on a show.
Hield. Bagley trying to free himself up. That one's good, and the Grizzly lead is cut down now to just two on the basket from Heald. Heald's gone 6 of 7 so far. Boy, he's making it look easy here, isn't he? We've gone about a minute and a half into the fourth quarter. Here's Morant. Good for basket number 7 tonight on a not-so-unlucky 13 shots.
The delicate touch on display there. Gotta love when Morant lets that floater fly off his fingertips. Beautiful.
That one goes in.
After a lackluster first half, he's taking charge offensively. We'll see how the defense responds.
Curry against Hield. Offensive rebound. Tries yet again. No good from Finney Smith.
And his pure defensive effort changed that shot from an easy one to a tough one.
And you know, technically, it's a high percentage look, but this is why we play the game.
For Memphis, they've gone 3 of 5 here in the fourth quarter. Pretty good numbers coming out of the break. Morant kicks to Curry. Out to the right wing. Beyond the arc. Sacramento grabs the miss. Bialica's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Ball stolen. Jackson finds Curry. It's stolen by Hill. Third minute of action now gone here in the fourth. Clock at 4 to take the lead. And the rebound goes to the Grizzlies. Curry way outside. Wasted no time on that shot, but it's off the mark. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Hield outside. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
That's his second personal foul.
At the line for your Kings, Buddy Hield. Taking 2 shots.
Shooting 2.
And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. And the Kings making a change here. House is checked in, and the Grizzlies also with a sub. Jaren Jackson, he's checked in for Jackson. And so he makes both from the line.
And you just knew he wasn't going to miss that one. Not with so much riding on.
There's the pass to Clark. Now a timeout called by Memphis.
And coach can't like what he's seeing, trying to get them refocused.
It's so easy to get run over when you lose even a little edge. Look for them to come out much more aggressive.
Of our Jordan player of the game, Buddy Hield.
And in terms of his shooting, this has been one of the more accurate performances you'll ever see. I mean, he's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good looks for himself. But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. That has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, guys, I caught Taylor Jenkins' message to his team. He said, we're too concerned with their shooters right now. We've got to close off the inside. They are gutting us. He pleaded with his guys. Come on, let's take a stand. Kevin?
Curry can't get it to go. The Kings have gone an outstanding 4 of 5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. Outside, Bagley. And the shot goes in. Bagley's got the lead up to 4 now for the Kings.
Stepping up, Bagley lives to compete. He wants the ball when the game is on the line.
Hield against Curry. To halt the run, sinks the triple. Curry's got 6 points in the quarter.
Just another reason why we have to love Stephen Curry. His ability to provide baskets in key situations.
Timeout called by the Kings. They're ahead by one. 1:43 left in the fourth quarter. Jackson's checked in.
USA!
1:43 left in the fourth quarter. Healed outside. It's deflected.
Well, this is where measurements don't tell the whole story. Clark is a tremendous shot blocker despite having an average wingspan. Tell you what, he's showing some kahunas there. That was a huge possession, and the young fella delivering time and time again.
Now here's Heald. Here's Harrell, and terrific work on the offensive glass when he picks up two. Harrell's got 4 points now in the quarter. 1:11 left to play here in the fourth. Now here's Curry. Clark kicks to Jackson. On its way from Curry for two. Rebound by Harrell. Kings have gone 6 of 9 on their field goal attempts since the start of the fourth quarter. B, the pass to Bagley. And the rejection by Jackson. Here's Morant. It falls!
Big-time basket at a big-time moment.
This is why we all watch. The NBA is about these moments.
Now here's Heald. 29 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Can't cash in from close range. Curry against Heald. And Buddy Heald is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Team seconds left in the fourth quarter. Outside Curry. Fires the three. Sacramento grabs the miss. Timeout called by the Kings. They trail by one. There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
This is where great coaching can pay dividends. These are the plays that people remember. I can't wait to see what he has devised.
To round two. Brilliant. thrilling fashion, guys, taking round one in what certainly will go down. Guys, it's one of the most competitive series this year.
And you always love a game set, and no disappointment here. And these guys are ready and excited for round two. Maybe a bit tired, but the adrenaline is still pumping.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Stefan, nice win after a tough loss in the last game. Was there a difference in how you all play tonight?
Yeah, for sure. Just make the easy play and share the ball. That's when we're really good. We have a lot of talent on the team. And if we get everybody involved, and that's what, whatever it takes to win tonight, we got to get it done.
Yeah, I know. Coach likes to see that ball moving around. Congratulations. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. Well, that'll do it for now. Glad you could join us for the first round of the Western Conference playoffs. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Steve Smith, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Have a great